There's Mr. H into his first carp. It won't be ready for the net yet, I don't think. I think Mark's caught the smallest fish in the pond. Eh? Oh yeah, they're really... Oh yeah, they hang on. I've had it screaming in here. Absolutely. Wow. It's 5:10 to 6. Mark's just trying to get a few in before it officially starts. Do you want to bring it over here, mate? Have you got it?
I know what's going to happen, I can feel it. 4 or 5 pounds.
About £5, that, mate. I'm going to sling him back. There's probably about another 50 of them to come today. I've got a rag for you because the way you make yourself. I have actually. No, I've got some rod vests.
You got a rag, no?
Yeah, there's one in my bag.
That's one thing.
Oh, my top colour, actually. Photograph.
Keep this one closed all the time. Keep seeing it.
Oh, them lads over there knew. What's my secret bait? It's dog biscuits, pink ones this week. You in? Good lad. I'm gonna land it. Yeah, we'll give you some dog biscuits.
Yeah, we'll give you some doggies for it, mate. How about that?
There's Mark into a carp at Langdale's Lake. Dogfish, floatfish, double dog biscuit.
Yeah, take it on biscuit. One more, I need all that boat. Take it on, mate.
Turn around, Mark. That's it. No, not that way, that way. So I can get that TFG badge on the back of your hat.
Think they'll let us do a second job still?
Dunno.
Yeah, it's probably staying, that. I can see it, yeah. Probably not got more.
Well, there were a lot of good fish on the island, a lot of good doubles. That's it, get yourself a double out of someone else's swim. Man, I can say about 100 from here. Hey.
Nearly fully scaled.
And here's Mark once again into a Maris Langworth carp. He's just cast his bait out a mere 5 minutes ago and he's already in to a lovely mirror carp. The fish seem to be congregating around the island, and double dog biscuit seems to be the bait of the day. Oh, some. What's your name, anyway? No. So all your swearing won't even matter. They're to the right of you. Yeah. See them? Yeah. In line with that geezer's float. Oh yeah, just there, just to bring it back a bit. That'll do. Just leave it there, Mark. Yeah, that's it. This is called pick your fish out, isn't it? Pick your fish and catch. Oh, Mark, leave it there at about 10 there.
Right, just move it a little bit. One right there, isn't it?
Yeah.
See it?
I can see it from here real well. That's alright, you'll catch one now. That lad's just lobbed the big lead in. Yeah, just leave it there. There's one underneath it. Don't, oh, you took it out of its way. Don't, just leave it there now. There's one coming towards it. There's one to the left hand side. Just leave it there, leave it there. There's about half a dozen there now. I suggest you reel in and cast back out about another 10 foot. There must be about a dozen there. You can see them? If that had been 10 foot to the left, you would have been laughing. They're right next to the island on the left, same distance out.
Yeah.
Whoa, there's one there, just showed himself. Between there and the underneath that, between there and that chap's float. You'd have to, you know where that chap's float is? Between here and there. Between where you've just cast out and that float, they're all underneath that. There's one there, can you see it? Did you see that ripple?
Yeah.
That's where they are. You've got a side cast from the right hand side into the island. Mark's after another car. Do you know they've all moved to the right hand side? Can you see them on the top?
Yeah.
Oh, there's one right underneath it. Just
I see it moved, then the actual bait.
Yeah, just keep it there. Oh, just stay there, it's coming towards it. Can you see it under the water? It's just swimming towards it. There's two just topped. Oh, they turn around. Man, there's some fish out there. Yeah, and then it's turned. Oh, where's it gone? Oh no! Just you watch, you don't tread on my rod. Not insured if you tread on it.
I'll piss her off.
You know, Eddie. You would, I know. I tell you what, I'm getting a cracking suntan here. Getting a cracking suntan study. Oh, don't you knock my chummies over. I have to go home and make some more.
These must be regular success,
right? Not as regular as me. Tell you what, right in front of you on the left, alright, on the left hand side, and this lad swim here, him with a white top on, there's about 10 fish in front of him. So while he's mucking about, just casting his swim. Oh yeah, I see it. Yeah, stop. Oh, it's going to take, is it going to have it? So the worst thing you can do is wear a white top when you're fishing. Spooks the fish. White. You suck. You know where you cast it the first time? That's where there's two carp next to it. That's better, isn't it? Now reel in. Put your tip under the water. Reel in slowly. Yeah, now reel it in and then recast. But leave loads of line out. That's it. Just cast from there. All that line hanging out. Just leave it there, there's two or three carp there. Yeah, so they're knocking its head off. Yep. That's all carp. I'll tell you what, I can pick all these carp up on screen.
Can?
Yep. Not blinking out, just took a photograph. Just took. No, really in, really in. Stop. Yeah, it's turning. It's coming up a second. It's coming up to where that splosh was. It's coming up to. Hey, there's a dog biscuit, and I'm going to chomp on it. Oh, it's turning. Here it comes. Oh yes, you get an even better one for your vis. Oh, can I touch it, Dad? What you ought to do is throw some dog biscuits out. It's a tangled one on the end of your rod. I need to come down there and show you how to do it properly. Man, there's just so many in that pack of them. Yeah, just get a bucket. Yep, got it. Oh!
Oh, you bastard, that was a good fish. Snap me off. Just snap me clean off.
There you are, carp basking in the sun at Marish's at Langworth. It's about 20 fish on the top. Just awaiting our dog biscuits to be cast in. Yeah, leave it there, it's two underneath it. Hold it, go on, go on. You just ruined it out of his mouth. Just leave it there. Yeah. The hesitation of the dog biscuit fisherman. Went to be hesitant to leave it. Oh no. Braid, eh? Fishing with braid, it don't go like line, does it? I mean, it might need to take your bail arm off. Just leave it there. The carp on the left come. Oh, it's coming now. Come on. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's turning. Oh, Mark, it was right underneath it. No, I'm not joking. It was just about to rise. Leave it there. But strike to the right, so that other lad will have to watch out. Just leave it there. There's half a dozen coming towards it. Alright, just leave it there, lad. There's one right near it. Oh, yes. Just stay there. There's Mark's dog biscuit waiting patiently. Here it comes. You got it?
No, I missed him again.
Oh, what? Oh man. Oh, that just leave that there. You got something wrong with you. Oh. Just come up to say hello there. It's like a. You need to strike a lot harder than that. No point just reeling it out of his mouth. You need to set the hooks in. All you're doing is reeling it out.
Took it
that
one.
Yeah, that's the sun's moving. The sun's moving higher and higher, they're moving round the other side. The sun's moving higher and higher up, but they're moving round. Oh, just leave that there. I just got a photograph of them fish on the top. Mm. Gotcha. Just hold it up above you, above, that's it. Just hold it there, sec. Photograph, yep, done. There he goes, to put his prize back. Common carp, about £7. Mark's into another dog biscuit caught. Fully scaled. I would say it's a Captain Pugwash, is it? And it's in. What's a better fish? What's a better fish? I'll take a photograph of it. Hey? I don't want a photograph. What kind of a stubborn ass is that? Jobs are good, mate. Took a photograph. Right. Yeah. Now, 10 mark, 10 fish marks had. I think we'll get a double later on. Been a bit far and few between today, I don't think anyone's had one. Whoa, did that take your bait? There's a carp just rolled on top. Oh yeah. They're like peas in a pod, they are. Look at them two. I think they were spawning together. They moved to the other side of the island. There's three or four underneath. Oh, man. That's what you call good braid, that, innit? Look, it snapped the tree off. There's two over there.
Sun's kicking in on my arm. Pushing that one
I'll tell you what, this is one of the best carp videos we've made. Mark, why don't you fish to the left of the island?
That was a number of tanks in there, wasn't it?
It has. Oh!
Right, it's gone wrong. That wasn't an invitation or what?
Well, it was swam at it, opened its mouth and shored it in.
5 foot away. I see him coming, didn't I?
He's still there, he's swimming. He's still there, Mark, look. He's under the water. Yeah. There he is. Can't miss him. Man, that's a good photograph. There he is, he's coming again. Oh, oh, he's there. Now he swam right near the island. We're not going to sit back and rain swims because there's plenty of fish down our end now. Hey, bang on, chop chop here, what? There you are, oh, carp, oh, he's back again. He's persistent, this lad, isn't he? Look, no. I don't believe it. Mark has got another carp. That'll be his 11th fish if he gets it in, and it's only 1 o'clock. Yeah, there's a couple of dark commons in here as well. So I had some out last week. I had a really dark level last week, 11 pounds. That's a dark. One of the first ones. He's an old boy, him. He's giving it everything he's got, though. Cross. That's Mark. Mark's into his, how many fish you had now? Is it your 12? 13th fish. I've nearly caught you up, I'm on my 8th. Yeah. That's because while you was losing those, I caught 4. What have you got in there, a zoo creature? What, a dace? Just imagine if you had your £2.5 test curve rods in. I think that fat fellow over there's got one of them, actually. It's as thick as my arm. Yeah. See where the wheel seat is? Put your hand on the wheel, top of the wheel seat. If you haven't got the back wind, put the back wind off. Yeah. And then just hold on to that black bit where your wheel goes. Yeah, hold on to there. Let the drag do the rest. And then you can drag it in and land it. Where's landing net? Top quality. Who got it in at last? chum's a good one. On the island, mate, on the island, right in front of you. There's two fish. Can you see them? Look, there they are. Here he comes. What a sucker. Oh, yes, there he is, just rising up. Oh, yes, he's coming. Leave it there. There's two there. There's one behind it and one in front of it. Oh. Them ones on the island. They keep popping up. There, it's right underneath it now. Oh, what? We can in the tree. Oh, I see that big fish in front of you. Just on the top. We've got some cracking photographs on here. Yeah, fish just under the surface. Cool, who's that? Oh, he's trying to underneath it. Did you take it?
No.
Oh, yeah. Give it a quick jerk. Hold it. Oh, just hold it there. It's right underneath it. Oh. Inside of her lips. They said she won't want to come near you for about a week. Oh, top quality, just leave it there. Chance of catching carp? You can't catch carp in here, mate. Excuse me. A blind man could catch carp in here, mate.
I want that fish as well, wasn't it? That caught from nowhere.
That's a nowhere fish.
They're easy until you get them right in the edge and that's it. Well, that's a big thing,
yeah. Yeah, I'd like to go back 20 years.
Right.
I'd like to go back 20 years. Dark fish, dark common.
Yeah, very dark. The old ones don't bite so much.
Probably been caught a million times. That's why.
Yeah, got pug noses, haven't
they? They've probably been caught since the, you know, day one. You mark into yet another dog biscuit. Is that number 15 of the session? The dog biscuit man. What?
It's filled when it goes through weeds all right down in the week.
Mark's still got this fish on. It's been on for now about 2 or 3 minutes and it's really been pulling him around the lake. He's now going to attempt to land it with his deep pan specimen match landing net. It's been Mark's first session on this lake and he's coming up to his 15th fish. Provided he doesn't bully this one too much. Well, didn't you think I meant it? So yeah, I told you it'd be fun. Well, here we are, back at the lake. Mark's into yet another one. His 16th fish.
Is it?
16th.
Yeah.
Yeah, and he's just had his a PB from here of 12 pounds 9 ounce common, also on a dog biscuit. Unfortunately, we didn't get it on film.
Getting on 5 in front of you.
Yeah, we had a 2.5 hour break while I've been filming you, it's while you've been a superstar.
This is one end of the
day. While you've been a superstar and catching 5 or 6 more. It snapped him off.
Oh, fucking
bleed, what an anti-climax. Never mind, better luck next time. Here's Mark with another 12 at a 12.5 common. He just had about a half an hour scrap with. Yeah, just hold that up a sec. I'm gonna have a photograph. Oh, cool photograph.
Take my glass off and set you.
I've decided to pack in for the evening. I'm actually burnt to a crisp. I barely move, so I'm just filming Mr. H for the last 45 minutes of the session and is into his 19th fish. He's making his debut on this water. He's only been using dog biscuits. He's had two doubles up to now. 2 12s.
Lads, can't get the finger action on this one, can you? When I had a run earlier, I burnt my finger, the braid went straight through it.
That's TFG braid for you, £14. What? Is it a deep dark leather?
Don't bump it. I must have had about £170 fish today.